The Ludlum Model 193-6 Survey Meter is a portable gamma survey instrument designed for surveying for gamma radiation. It's very effective for scanning large objects such as trucks or piles of scrap metal. The Model 193-6 has a large scintillation-type detector on the end of a 4-foot-long pole that provides for an extended reach. The instrument also incorporates audible and visual alarms that are automatically set by the instrument when it is powered up. The survey techniques shown in this video are strictly for demonstration purposes and are not meant to supplant regulatory requirements or your company's policies and practices. The meter handle was removed in some parts of this video to make it easier to see the front of the meter. Here is a quick start guide. Turn the rotary switch to the battery check position and ensure the needle goes into the battery OK portion of the display. If not, insert new batteries. If you have a check source, take a reading to see if the instrument reads correctly. To do this, place the source next to the detector and make sure it reads within 20% of the recorded reading. In this example, the meter is indicating approximately 140 microR per hour. The reference check source reading can be found on the Ludlum calibration sticker on the side of the instrument. Turn the instrument off and then turn it back on in a place away from the check source or any suspected radioactive material and wait for the 8-second background. Background radiation levels are measured and remembered by the instrument immediately following power-up. Hold the detector so that the bottom is from 1 to 6 inches from the surface to be surveyed. Slowly move the detector over the surface being surveyed. Audible beeps should be heard with increasing frequency as the detector comes closer to a radioactive source and the meter needle will deflect upscale. The range selector switch is a 6-position rotary switch labeled off, bat, times 1000, times 100, times 10, and times 1. Move the range selector switch to one of the range multipliers to make a measurement. To determine the actual reading, multiply the scale readings by the range multiplier. In this picture, the needle is on the 0.62 mark, and the knob is on the times 100 position. So the actual reading is 0.62 times 100, or 62 microR per hour. The audio on-off toggle switch is used to silence the clicks coming from the speaker located on the left side of the instrument. The frequency of the clicks is relative to the rate of the incoming pulses. The FS toggle switch determines the meter response time. Selecting the fast F position of the toggle switch provides 90% of full-scale meter deflection in approximately 4 seconds. In the slow S position, 90% of full-scale meter deflection takes approximately 22 seconds. In most circumstances, the Model 193-6 should be used with the switch in the F or fast position. The alarm light flashes when radiation levels rise above background. When the meter pointer deflects above the fixed alarm set point, this red lamp illuminates continuously. In both cases, the visual alarms will be accompanied by an audible alarm. When the reset button is pushed, it provides a rapid means of driving the meter needle to zero. Pressing reset also causes an 8-second background update. During these 8 seconds, the speaker will emit beeps and the alarm light will flash every half second. A headphone jack is located near the detector connector. The battery compartment is located on the front of the meter. The Model 193-6 uses 2 D-cell batteries. These can be regular or rechargeable batteries, although the instrument is not capable of recharging batteries. The meter can sense a detector failure if it receives no counts from the detector for 8 seconds. In the event this occurs, the instrument will beep rapidly and displays a meter reading of 0. The instrument should be taken out of service until it is repaired. The Model 193-6 is typically used to detect naturally occurring radioactive material, which is commonly called by its abbreviation, NORM. The amount of naturally occurring background radiation is dependent upon geographical location, environmental factors, and other conditions. Some materials are naturally radioactive, such as smoke detectors, some antique types of porcelain, certain minerals dug from the ground, and old lantern mantles. Over time, NORM can build up in pipes and valves. People that have had certain medical procedures can be radioactive for up to several days. Be sure it is not a person setting off the alarm. Normal variations in background radiation will occasionally cause the instrument to beep. However, multiple beeps indicate an increase in the level of radiation and the possible presence of radioactive material. Remember, when surveying for radiation, it is locating and measuring radiation above background. That is the objective. That concludes our video on the model 193-6 extended reach microR meter. Thanks for watching!